Good morning, student. I, Purnima, welcome you to my class. In my previous video, we were doing the lesson, The Proposal, written by Anton Chekhov. And in today's video classes, we will be doing the question answer of this lesson, the important question from the sample paper, and what is important, what is the message, all this thing we will discuss today. So let's start, student. So the proposal, first of all, it is written by Anton Chekhov. He is a Russian writer, okay, and he was a great playwright and story writer. He was born on 29 January 1860 in a village in southern Russia. His father ran a grocery store. His mother, Eugenia, was an excellent storyteller. Chekhov was an established physician. He is considered to be among the greatest writer of short story in the world. Chekhov once said, "Medicine is my lawful wife and literature is my mistress." So these were the words, and he has proved also that he loved his mistress so well, so much. He has given a lot of literary work to our readers. Now, this is a short story, and I would like to tell all the important points of the story before we discuss the question answer. Once again, we will revise the important parts of the story. Okay. So, let's start. Now, Lamo and Chekhov are both neighbors, and both are belong from the landlord family, so financial problem they did not have in their lives. So both of them are rich neighbors, both are from the landlord family, and of course students, they don't have to face any financial problem. Lamo comes to Chekhov's house with a proposal of marriage with Chekhov's daughter Natalia. So he had seen the girl for a long time. She can cook. She was a well-educated girl. She was also a good-looking girl. So he thought this is a better match, suitable match for him. So Lomo came to Chekhov's house with a proposal of marriage, okay, with his daughter Natalia. Lomo is 35 and wants to lead a peaceful married life. So he is 35. He wanted to lead a peaceful married life. He thinks that Natalia is an excellent housekeeper and not bad looking. He is excited and forgets the purpose of his visit. He starts quarreling with her over Oxen Meadow, which he is sure that it is his property, but on the contrary, it is Natalia who thinks that it is her property. So now the quarrel begins. Natalia opposes Lomo and claims that Oxen Meadows belongs to them. Lomo is ready to show the document to prove his ownership of Oxen Meadow. He is ready to make Oxen Meadow a present to her. Chekhov enters and adds fuel to the fire. Chekhov sides with his daughter Natalia. Lomo threatens to go to the court. They quarrel and indulge in abusing and insulting each other. Natalia came to know that Lomo has come there with a proposal of marriage. She blames her father for not telling her about it before. She threatens to die if Chekhov doesn't bring Lomo back. Lomo returns, and now they pick up a new quarrel over their dogs. Natalia said that her dog Squeezer is far superior to Lomo's dog Guess. Lomo is excited and his palpitations start rising. He falls down in the armchair and loses his consciousness. Chupko is confused and threatens to cut his throat or shoot himself. Chupko doesn't want to miss this opportunity. He makes them embrace and kiss each other. Chupko blesses them a happy married life. So Natalia is a talkative and short temper. She is very much concerned about her family honor and land. She is argumentative also. She argues with Lamo about the ownership of Oxen Meadow and the superiority of her dog Squeezer. She is very keen to get married. Well, while Stephen Stevenage Chupko is a landowner, he has a helping nature towards Lomo, it seems, because when he comes to his house, he tells to himself that if he want to have money this time, I'm not going to give. That means he must be giving money whenever he was in need. He loves his daughter and plays the role of a good father. He is in search for a good match for his daughter. He is a good selector of words. He called Lomo my angel, treasure, etc. This shows his cunningness also. When Chupko finds Lomo fighting with Natalia, he immediately changes and starts to support his daughter. He uses many ill words for Lomo and also tell him to leave his house. Okay, so this is all the important points of the story, and now I am going to do the question answers with you. So now we will be doing the question answer of this lesson. I've already discussed with you the important points, and once again I will write the important points on the board, like Lomo arrives with a proposal of marriage. So whenever you children prepare a chapter, you have to prepare point wise so that you can know which points, which points comes before, which points come afterward, and in the sequence also you must know all the important point of the lesson. So first point is Lomo's proposal of marriage to Natalia. He comes to her house. This was the first point. Lomo arrives with a proposal of marriage. Okay, when the father come to know that he came for proposal of his daughter, he is happy. In fact, being a father, he also want that his father should his daughter should get married in time. So he is also interested. And Lomo and Natalia is left alone. So second point is Lomo and Natalia left alone. Third point. Quarrel over Oxen Meadow. Now when they are left alone, instead of talking, they are fighting over the land, and finally they fight with the dogs, for their dogs also. Okay. And here, children, I think I should tell you, here Chupko is not supporting Lomo, who wanted to become his son-in-law. He is supporting his daughter. He takes his side and he adds fuel to the fire. The fight is started taking place more. Both of them become more aggressive and they fight. Okay. Now the quarrel is over Oxen Meadow. Okay, as I told you, Lomo tells her that he has the privilege of knowing her family. The Lomo and the Chupkos have always had the most friendly relations. He tells that his Oxen Meadow touch her brushwood. And that belongs to them. So if I take place, I also told you, father supports the daughter and Chupkio adds fuel to the fire. Natalia knows of the marriage proposal. Suddenly, Natalia, she comes to know about the marriage proposal. Okay. Fifth point is Chupko adds fuel to the fire and support his daughter. Sixth, Natalia came to know the proposal of Chupko. Natalia came to know about the proposal of Chupko. Okay, and when she came to know the proposal of Chupko, she feels happy and she forget all her fight. In the meantime, he was hurt and he was getting nervous pricked in Lamo, and she calls her. She calls Lamo. Okay. So, his heart ache. He feels numb. Chupko calls Lamo a malicious double-faced intruder. Natalia is surprised when Chupko tells that Lamo has come with a proposal of marriage. She blames her father of not telling it before. She starts shouting, "Bring him back, bring him back." Chupko is surprised at the change in her. She threatens her father that she will die if Lamo is not brought back. Lamo enters and picks up another quarrel with Natalia. So again they fight. Okay, so here again the fight is here. Again, they fight for a dog. So when he was called, again a fight took place, and this time the fight took place because of the dog. Okay. Well, Lamo falls on armchair. Finally, children, they decided to get married, but it continued with the fight. So now I'm going to discuss the important question answer of this lesson. First, we will be doing the textual question answer. So, question number one is, what does Chupko at first suspect that Lamo has come for? Is he sincere when he later says, "And I've always loved you, my angel, as if you were my own son"? Find reason for your answer from the play. Now, Chupko doesn't have a very high regard for Lamo. At first, he suspects that Lamo has come to him for borrowing money. He has done so earlier too. He claims that he loves Lamo and calls him an angel. Lamo has been like his own son. He doesn't seem to be sincere in what he says. He's exposed when he starts quarreling with Lamo on Oxen Meadow and the dogs. He abused Lamo and sides with his daughter Natalia. Chupko says of question number two. Chupko says of Natalia as if she won't consent. She is in love. She is like a lovesick cat. Would you agree? Find reason for your answer. This is true up to a great extent. Her father calls Natalia a lovesick cat. She may not love Lamo sincerely and truly, but one thing is clear. She is dying to marry Lamo. When she comes to know that Lamo came with a proposal of marriage, she starts weeping. She presses her father to bring Lamo back. Even in the end, she wastes no time in giving her hand in the hand of Lamo. Okay. So, children, now there's some words and expression in the play that the characters used to speak about each other, and the accusation and insult they heard at each other are example. For example, Lamo in the end calls Chupko an intriguer, but earlier Chupko has himself called Lamo a malicious, double-faced intriguer. Again, Lamo begins by describing Natalia as an excellent housekeeper, not bad-looking, well-educated. All characters in the play indulge in accusations and insult here. Lamo calls Chupko malicious, old rat, fool, the stuffed sausage, okay, a land grabber, double-faced, villain, and accuser. Chupko calls Lamo lunatic, petty figure, drunkard, gambler, scarecrow, backbiter, and turnip host. Natalia called Lamo the monster and rascal. Chupko called Lamo's father a guzzling gambler. Lamo called Natalia well-educated, excellent housekeeper, and not bad-looking. Okay, so all these things are there, and children, so you have to see all these things, and the other questions is not related with the language part, so I'm not discussing it. Only language questions I'm discussing it here. Now I'm going to do some important question and answer. How does Lamo come to Chupko? How does Chupko react to his visit? Lamo, a landlord, pays visit to Chupko. The purpose of his visit is quite clear. He has come with a proposal of marriage. He is interested in marrying Natalia, who he considers a good housekeeper and not bad looking. Chupko misunderstands the proposal of Lamo's visit. He thinks that he has come to borrow money from him. However, when he comes to know that he has come with a marriage proposal, he is overjoyed and excited. So now, once again, children, why is Chupko surprised at Lamo wearing of a formal dress when he comes to meet him? Because he never appears as if he were paying a New Year Eve's visit, he thinks, and then he comes to know that Lamo has come for the proposal of his daughter. Why do both the families of Lamo and Chupko claim the ownership of Oxen Meadow? Oxen Meadow becomes a bone of connection between the two families. Lamo thinks that Oxen Meadow, that does the birch forest of Chupko, belonging to him. His aunt grandmother gave the free use of the meadows to the peasant of Natalia's father's grandfather. In return, they were to make bricks for them. Natalia opposed it by saying that their land extend to burnt Mars. It means that Oxen Meadow belongs to them. Why does Natalia think that Lamo's behavior is strange and he is simply joking and making fun of her? Natalia thinks that Lamo's behavior is quite strange. He is only joking and making fun of her. She claims that they have Oxen Meadow for nearly 300 years. She is suddenly told that it is not theirs. It is strange that Lamo is making a present of the meadow to them, which are not owned by him. It is unlike a good neighbors and a friend. So, children, this is there. Now, children, Natalia is very much confused here, and she feels that Oxen Meadow belongs to them. Now, how does Chupko react when Lamo comes to sense? We will discuss this. Describe the physical condition and health of Lamo. Lamo is 35 years old. He doesn't enjoy a good health. He is easily excited. He suffers from palpitations. If he his feet are numbed, he can't express himself like a calm and composed man. He can't hear too much tension and excitement. He throws himself down in an armchair and becomes unconscious soon. Only when water is sprinkled over his face, he comes to sense. What happens when Lomo is thought to be almost dead? Lomo has come with a proposal of marrying Natalia. When he falls down unconscious in an armchair, both Natalia and Chupko are unnerved and worried. She starts crying, thinking him dead. Chupko calls for a doctor. He threatens to shoot himself or cut his throat. When Lomo comes to sense, Chupko grabs the opportunity and blesses them for a happy married life. How does Chupko react when Lomo comes to senses? Lomo, unconsciousness, unnerved both Chupko and his daughter Natalia. He is thought to be dead. Chupko thinks that a golden opportunity has been lost. He thinks of shooting himself or cutting his throat. When Lomo comes to sense, Chupko doesn't lose the opportunity. He cries, "Hurry up and get married." He is at once blesses both of them. Now, does justify the title of the play the proposal, or what is the theme or the message of the proposal? A very nice and interesting question, children. Anton Chupko, the writer, has aptly titled this play the proposal. The title justifies the main theme, the marriage of Natalia and Lomo. No doubt both Lomo and Natalia want to be life partner. However, unnecessary quarrel over Oxen Meadow and their dogs Squeezer and Guest temporarily spoil their game. The message is very clear. The main issue must not be clouded and lost sight of by indulging in unnecessary and unavoidable quarrel. So we must not deviate from our main issue. Okay. Now, Chupko has all the attributes of quarrelsome rich Russian landlord. Means he is a mirror of the landlord, how they used to live. So he is just an image of the society of the landlord of Russia. Chupko has all the attributes of a quarrelsome rich Russian landlord. Instead of solving the problem, he only adds fuel into the fire in their quarrel over Oxen Meadow and the dogs, justify the statement. Chupko represents a typical rich landlord of 19th century Russia. He seems to be fairly rich and resourceful. Even his neighbor Lomo acknowledges the frequent help rendered to him by Chupko. He lent his threshing machine to Lomo. On account of this help, he has to put off their own threshing till November. Chupko is quite practical. He knows that Lomo can be a good match for his daughter Natalia. So he at once gives his assent to Lomo's proposal of marrying her. Actually, he has been waiting for such a proposal for a long time. Chupko is a landlord and can't resist his hunger for land. He opposes the claim of Lomo over the ownership of Oxen Meadow. He even threatens to send his mowers out to the meadow. Chupko can be quite quarrelsome, abusing and insulting. He always sides with his daughter. He picks up a quarrel on Oxen Meadow. He calls Lomo a land grabber and villain. He abuses his grandfather of being a drunkard and his father a gambler. He jumps into the quarrel and adds only fuel to the fire. However, Chupko is a great opportunity. He grabs the opportunity the moment Lomo comes into the senses. He makes Natalia kiss and embrace Lomo and get them married. So, children, and I already we have discussed that the title of the lesson. Okay. Doesn't it look ridiculous and childish to see mature person like Natalia, Lomo and Chupko quarreling over their dogs Squeezer and Guess? Give a reason answer. Natalia and Lomo are matured person, but they behave like kids. They can be childish and ridiculous on occasion. They easily forget the main issue, the proposal of marriage. No doubt Natalia is a lovesick cat and is trying to marry Lomo. Even Lomo considered Natalia a good housekeeper and he feels that she can be a suitable girl in his life and nice. She could be a nice wife to him. such a good looking and educated woman can be an ideal wife for him. But both of them failed to come to the main issue. After the dispute over the ownership of Oxen Meadow is resolved, they pick a fresh quarrel over their dogs. Their behavior is childish and unwanted. Considering their mature age, their dogs Squeezer and Guess become the symbol of their vanity and false pride. Natalia calls her Squeezer a thoroughbred animal of a noble breed. Chupkov jumps into the quarrel. He calls Squeezer the best dog in the district. He calls Lamour dog Guess old and short in the muzzle. That is free for all. Abuses and insults are exchanged. Lamour calls Chupkov an intrigue, old rat and Jesuit. Chupkov calls Lamour boy, pup and milksop fool. The quarrel ends only when Lamour lies down unconscious in an armchair. And children, then Natalia, she feels sorry and finally they get married, what we hope. But I feel they will be fighting forever. So with this, I end my video here. Thank you and have a nice day ahead. Goodbye.